Welcome to another Take Three for Politics. Brad Schmidt here with Andrew Thien. We'll be breaking down some of Portland City Hall's big stories of the week. Andrew, let's start it off. What's up with Gail Shibley?
Well, Gail Shibley, Mayor Charlie Hale's former chief of staff, was sued this week by a former subordinate who alleged also last year in a state civil rights complaint that was subsequently withdrawn that Shibley harassed him based on his status as an HIV positive individual. Shibley's consistently said that's just not true. This is ridiculous. Now it's about money. He's seeking $350,000. But even with Gail gone, working for the state youth authority, this is still sticking around, and you know, this suit could continue in the news with the mayor and the city being involved. Beyond that, there are big picture issues at play here in Portland. The Portland building and Veterans Memorial Coliseum, what's going on with those two big projects?
Yeah, the city needs to figure out sort of where it wants to spend its money. Mm-hmm. And the Portland building is the administrative headquarters for the city. They've been trying to figure out what to do with it because of water intrusion issues and also seismic deficiencies. Mm-hmm. The issue right now is, do they do anything? The price tag is estimated at about $200 million for a major gut job of the building. They had a work session this week where essentially they were warned this is going to be the most complicated project that you've ever taken on.
No pressure.
Yeah, exactly. Right. And so think carefully and you know, make sure that you understand that there's going to be lots of trade-offs. Separately, there's Veterans Memorial Coliseum, which is about 50 years old. It's another one of those, what are we going to do? The city's been wrestling with that for years and years and years. They came up with a new study, which is pretty comprehensive, that looks at different options. What if we keep the Portland Winterhawks there and we upgrade the facility? What if we turn it into a concert venue and we knock out the windows and we knock out part of the bowl? What if we turn it into an indoor track facility? The prices range from about $35 million all the way up to about $143 million. Now, the problem is that the revenue stream that would come from any of those big changes wouldn't be enough to really pay off the debt. So the city's going to have to get pretty creative if they want to go forward. Switching gears yet again, speaking of, I guess, getting creative, perhaps, the city council's still trying to figure out what to do with Hempstock.
So Hempstock, right, if you recall, is this festival. It's been around for 11 years. It's supposed to be a celebration of marijuana and hemp for all uses. And they've consistently been at odds with the Parks Bureau. They were given a second chance last year, had their event at Waterfront Park. The city said it was the same as it's been, just tons of people smoking pot everywhere, selling to undercover cops, et cetera. City Council, for the second year in a row, really put their neck out there and said, no, this festival is a free speech issue. This year, what was different was Commissioner Saltzman directly said, look, there's a double standard for this marijuana festival in comparison to rowdy events like the Brewfest and the Blues Festival, which are held on the waterfront. It is Portland, Oregon. People smoke marijuana in public. And the city council pretty much said that's a fact. It's an imperfect festival. We'll see what happens this year.
But they're going to get the permit.
It sounds like they're going to get the permit. It's going to be sometime in the next month. Paul Stanford, the organizer, wants it to be on the same weekend as recreational marijuana sales, kind of as a symbolic gesture, but the mayor said he wants to check it out, so it'll be interesting to see if there's some political leaders in attendance at the festival.
Well, there you go, mark your calendars. Thanks for taking the time to chat with us here, and we'll catch you next time.